The New York Knicks are yet again interested in some more players in the 2020 NBA free agency, this time actually currently being reported that the Knicks are heavily, aggressively pursuing Gordon Hayward. That's all being reported by Mark Steins. Now, what is actually very interesting about this as well is we have had a lot of Knicks news and a lot of Gordon Hayward news as well very recently, with multiple reports saying that Gordon Hayward had actually declined his $34 million player option. That was being reported by Shams. It does look like he really, really wants to get out of Boston, just doesn't like it there. You know, again, with the way he's been sort of traded and the way that he's kind of talked about it, it's obvious that he doesn't want to play there. And, you know, it's even more obvious now that he's declined his $34 million player option. Before all of this happened, though, there was a big rumor that Gordon Hayward for Andre Drummond trade was actually being nearly almost finalized. Like, some people were saying that it was heating up quite a bit to the point where it could definitely be potentially happening. That was all being reported by NBC Sports Boston. But now that Gordon Hayward has declined his $34 million player option, I can't really see that happening at all. I mean, it would have to be a sign and trade. Not just that, I feel like that is a massive loss for the Cleveland Cavaliers. Like, let's just say they do trade Drummond for Hayward. That's terrible for the Cavaliers. Like, they don't need a small forward like Hayward now, especially after just getting Okoro. Yes, you could play Hayward as maybe that small ball type of power forward type of player, especially if you get rid of Kevin Love. But Andre Drummond is very crucial, I feel like, to the team, especially if they can't get a first-round pick out of him. I would have thought if it was going to be a swap, it would have been Gordon Hayward and a first-round pick for Andre Drummond. That just obviously makes the most amount of sense, and I feel like that's what the Cavs would have done. But now that Hayward has declined it, he can pretty much go wherever he wants to go in this free agency. The Knicks have actually had a pretty busy day as well, where they waived Taj Gibson. They declined a Bobby Portis's $15.7 million team option, and they actually waived Elfrid Payton, which came at a bit of a surprise to me. I don't really know why they did that as well, but again, that was all being reported by Shams, so it has been a pretty busy day for the New York Knicks, especially after a pretty successful draft where they were able to get Obi Toppin, arguably the steal of the draft with the 8th overall pick. Now, why are the New York Knicks interested in Gordon Hayward, and why would Gordon Hayward actually want to go to the Knicks? Now, I believe there are a couple teams on where Hayward will potentially go. In my opinion, he would definitely be looking at Indiana. I believe he actually is from Indiana. I think he might have even gone to college there. I could be wrong. I know it's either one of them or maybe even both, but he definitely has some ties to Indiana. So, again, there were a lot of reports there that the Pacers would try and do a sign and trade with him. I feel like Gordon Hayward is worth max $15 million. I can't really see any team signing him over that, especially after his injuries and lack of defense that he does provide on the floor. Even though he is still pretty good offensively, I could definitely see a team like the Indiana Pacers getting him for about $15 million a season, or even the New York Knicks. Now, why would the Knicks get him, considering as of late, they have no point guard? They have a very young squad of RJ Barrett, Kevin Knox, Obi Toppin, and Mitchell Robinson. Are they just going to keep going young? Like, why would they get Gordon Hayward? Now, the current really big rumor is that the New York Knicks are going to be heavily trying to get Russell Westbrook to the team to be the point guard. There was a lot of rumors saying that they were actually originally going to get Chris Paul, and then that Chris Paul was going to persuade DeMar DeRozan, Carmelo Anthony, and Danilo Gallinari to potentially join the team. But now that we obviously know that Chris Paul has been traded to the Phoenix Suns, I believe DeMar actually picked up his player option. That obviously doesn't seem to be the case. DeMar will probably get traded to, obviously, a team that he can't really pick from now. And I expect Carmelo to re-sign with the Portland Trail Blazers. And I think Gallinari will look to go elsewhere. For example, I think he might actually look to go to the Miami Heat or some team like that. So, it kind of leaves the New York Knicks with really only one option now that Chris Paul has obviously been traded to Phoenix, and that is Russell Westbrook. And I guess there is another option in Fred VanVleet, but I kind of feel like he might either go to Detroit or stay with Toronto. So for the Knicks to go out now and get Russell Westbrook, they're probably going to trade maybe a couple future firsts or whatever. That Dallas pick will probably be involved. They'll probably, you know, flip maybe some young players like Dennis Smith or something like that. I doubt they're going to want to get rid of Frank Ntilikina. Obviously, RJ Barrett and Mitchell Robinson and Obi Toppin, you would think, would be three untouchables that they will not want to move to Houston at all. And now, I think, honestly, if you could get Gordon Hayward, you know, to come to the team as well, he'll definitely be more, you know, wanting to join the team, especially if they can get a point guard like Russell Westbrook. Then you actually kind of see, like, a good squad coming. Yes, Gallinari might not want to join now that Chris Paul isn't there, but that doesn't mean Gallinari might not want to join if, you know, Russell Westbrook and Gordon Hayward's there. Like, imagine that team real quick. Let's just say, you know, Hayward and Westbrook's a thing, and we'll even say Gallinari actually decides to go there. That is a really mean starting five with a really nice bench unit. I mean, that is a really good team. You'll have Russell Westbrook at point guard, RJ Barrett at shooting guard, Gordon Hayward at small forward, Danilo Gallinari at power forward, with Mitchell Robinson at center. Not only is that a very nice young starting five, but it's also got some very, you know, nice older players in Westbrook, Hayward, and Gallinari on the team. Then off the bench, you'll have Obi Toppin as your sixth man, who's only 22 years of age. Straight away, he'll play a lot of minutes at the forward position, most likely power forward, but also sprinkle maybe at small forward as well. And then they'll also have, you know, potentially Frank Ntilikina, Dennis Smith Jr. if they keep him, which I doubt they'll be really wanting to give him minutes. And honestly, just it will keep going on, and they'll obviously probably go and still try and sign Carmelo Anthony. I've heard they're also interested in players like Justin Holiday, etc. They'll be definitely really keen on all of these players. And honestly, that is actually a nice team in the East. Like, if we look at it, you will have, I believe he's like 20, no, he's like 31 now or something, or 30 years old. Actually, I think he's 32. You'll have 32-year-old Russell Westbrook at point guard. You'll have about 20-year-old RJ Barrett at shooting guard. I think he's about 30 years old as well, Gordon Hayward. Pretty similar thing with Gallinari at power forward. And then like 21, 22-year-old Mitch Robinson. Again, and a couple of really nice young starting players. A couple of really nice older, you know, starting players as well. And then off the bench, you'll have young players like Obi Toppin, who's only 22. Ntilikina's about only 22. Dennis Smith, they keep him, is about only 22. Again, Kevin Knox as well, who most likely still be on the team if they don't trade him. He's about 21. It's just a really nice young team, and they could still definitely go out and sign these players like Carmelo Anthony and etc., who will also be potentially interested in joining the team. So a lot of stuff is happening for New York at the moment. Even though they did miss out on Chris Paul and DeMar DeRozan, still doesn't mean they can't get Danilo Gallinari, Russell Westbrook, Carmelo Anthony, Gordon Hayward, and even still try and maybe even trade for DeMar and Victor Oladipo. So again, I'm very keen to see what New York is going to do. I feel like it was extremely good of them to wait in the draft and not actually trade up. Shows that their new GM may actually know what he's doing. He decided to wait and not trade up. And now Obi Toppin is currently chilling on the team. And he really wanted to go to New York, it looked like, as well. I believe his favorite destinations were New York and Cleveland. So because he was able to get to, you know, New York, which I believe is the state he is from, obviously very, very good for Obi Toppin as well. So again, I'm very interested to see what players the Knicks are going to get now that they've, you know, declined players like Bobby Portis, is like $15 million contract. You would think that they are going to go out and get some of these players. And if you think about it as well, what a deal. If you can get Gordon Hayward at $15 million, if you're pretty much playing Gordon Hayward the exact same that you were playing Bobby Portis, like just comparing the players, one averages about 10 points per game, very inconsistent, and one in Gordon Hayward is still a scoring machine, averaging about 18 points per game. So again, I'm very keen and very interested to see what the New York Knicks are going to do. But anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for all the latest NBA news and NBA content. Of course, don't forget to comment in the comment section down below. What are your thoughts and opinions on this? Do you guys think it'd be a good move for the New York Knicks to go out and get Gordon Hayward? Do you guys think it'd be a bad move? Again, I definitely would really like to know all of your thoughts and opinions on this down below. But of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for the latest NBA content and sports-related content in general. Don't forget to subscribe to my gaming channel, MIRO/longchannels. Links for them will all be in the description down below. But as I'll sign off to thank you guys so much for watching this video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and comment. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.